Okay, sorry about that. That was I'm here on Monday and they're still running the bells, so that was the bell. So, moving on to multiplying radicals. When you multiply radicals, you multiply the numbers that are outside together and the numbers that are inside the radical together. Now, when you're adding, you can only add them if they have like terms. So, I would be able to add these because they're both the square root of 3, just like I can add 2x and 3x since they both have an x. And so, if this was a plus sign, I would still be able to add this, just like I would still have an x here. I would just need to know how many I have. I would still have a square root of 3. I would just have to know how many I have, which would be 6 if that was addition. But you cannot add radicals if they don't have the same thing under the radical. But we're just simplifying by multiplying. We're focusing on that. So if I multiply the outside numbers, 2 times 4 is 8. So I would have an 8 on the outside. I would also multiply the numbers inside the radical. 3 times 3 is 9. Now, I would never give this as my final answer because it's not simplified. 9 is a perfect square, just like it was over here. So I can take the square root of a 9 and it comes out as a 3. Now, when it comes out, now this is multiplication since they're written right beside each other without a symbol. So when I bring that 3 out, it has to multiply by the 8 that's already out there, and I would get 24. So if you do that enough times, you just realize, well, every time I multiply the square root of 3 times the square root of 3, I get a 3 outside the radical. And that's because when you multiply a number by itself, it's the same thing as squaring that. So multiplying square root of 3 by itself is the same thing as taking the square root of 3 and squaring it. And we understand that square roots and squaring are inverse operations. They undo each other. And so that simply leaves me with a 3, and I don't have a radical remaining anymore. So I get 24 as my final answer. Now, you could put this in your calculator and get that answer, but when you have a problem like this, your calculator would give you a decimal, and that's not what we want. We want exact answers. So we're going to go through that process again. We're going to multiply the outside numbers together. 3 times 2 is 6, and we're going to multiply the inside numbers together. No, this is also a whole number, so it would work on this one too. Well, 2 times 18 is 36. And so I could take the square root of 36 because it's a perfect square and bring it out as a 6, and it would have to multiply by the 6 out there. And so that would be 36. Nothing's left in the radical. Now, every time you multiply this, it's not going to just do away with the radical. So, for example, if I gave you 3 square roots of 2 times 2 square roots of, let's see, 6, I'll do that. Okay, so we would go through the same process. 3 times 2 is 6, and underneath the radicals, 2 times 6 is 12. Well, 12 is not a perfect square, but it also is not completely simplified in this form. So again, if I went through this process and I put a 12 right here, if you didn't know the factors of 12, you could get all the numbers that multiply to get 12, and they are 1 times 12, 2 times 6, and 3 times 4. And so we're looking for perfect square factors, and remember, one is not helpful. So the next pair has 2 and 6, and neither one of those are perfect squares, so I don't want to split 12 into 2 times 6. The next factor pair is 3 and 4. 3 is not a perfect square, but 4 is. So I'm going to rewrite the 12 underneath the radical as 3 times 4. Those are still equivalent to each other. They're the same thing. I've just written it in a different way. The 4 is a perfect square, so I'm going to circle that to remind myself I can take the square root of 4, and it comes out as a 2. Now, there's already a 6 out there, so remember, you're going to multiply those together. 2 times 6 is 12, but we still have a radical remaining. That 3 is still stuck under the radical. So these two, if you put them in your calculator as they are, you would get the correct answer. But if you put this in your calculator, it's going to give you a decimal answer, and which would be fine if you were told what to round to. But if you're not, you're expected to give an exact answer, and that would be 12 square roots of 3. So you would not get full credit for 6 square roots of 12 any more than you would for giving me a fraction for eights. That's not simplified. So you want to make sure that you simplify it. And by the way, you want to simplify it all the way. Just like a fraction, I could simplify this down to 2/4, but that's not completely simplified until I get down to 1/2. That happens a lot of times with radicals too. You want to make sure the number under the radical has no more perfect square factors. So 3, the only thing that multiplies to get 3 are 1 and 3, and that would not simplify it farther. So the third thing I want to review with you is what you learned last year in algebra. Most of the times when you're giving an answer in simplified form, it's not acceptable to leave a radical in the denominator. And so we do a process that's called rationalizing the denominator. So remember, if you have a radical in the denominator of a number that's not a perfect square, it's an irrational number, and we want it to be rational. So that's why it's called rationalizing the denominator. You want the denominator to contain a rational number. So we're going to use the rule that we learned over here, that when you multiply a radical by itself, you get rid of the radical. The square root of 3 times the square root of 3 is simply 3, no radical remaining. And so I'm going to use that understanding plus the understanding that if I have a number as a fraction over itself, anything divided by itself is simply 1. And if I multiply a number by 1, I'm not changing its value. So it's those understandings that are going to help me rationalize this denominator. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to multiply the denominator by the square root of 3. And I know that that will get rid of that radical and leave me with just a 3. But mathematically, that's not legal to do because I've changed the whole value of that problem by simply multiplying the denominator by the square root of 3. So to keep it the same value, I'm also going to multiply the numerator by the square root of 3. So now I'm really just multiplying this number by 1 because the square root of 3 over the square root of 3 is 1. And so I'm not changing the value of the number, I'm just rearranging things so that the denominator has a rational number. So now in the numerator, I can't multiply that 2 and 3 together because the 2's outside the radical and the 3's inside. And so I would simply write that as 2 square roots of 3. In the denominator, the square root of 3 times the square root of 3 is the square root of 9, which remember is simply 3. So it no longer has a radical in the denominator. You would of course want to make sure that this is completely simplified. But remember, only numbers outside can simplify with each other. I can't cancel these 3's because that 3's in a radical and this 3's not. And so if this were a number that was a multiple of 3, I could do some simplifying there. So for instance, if that was 6 and this was a 3, that would simplify to simply 2. But this is simplified as it is. So we'll do that one more time. Again, I have a square root of 3, and the reason why I'm practicing this is one that'll come up a lot in our problems today. And so again, I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to multiply the numerator and the denominator by the square root of 3. If this were a square root of 2, then I'd be multiplying by the square root of 2 over the square root of 2. If this were the square root of 5, I would multiply by the square root of 5 over the square root of 5. It's whatever this radical is that you're going to multiply the numerator and denominator by. So now, remember, you can only multiply the numbers outside and numbers inside together. So the 3 doesn't have a number outside to multiply with. It's an understood 1. So I'm still going to have a 3 outside the radical. Inside the radical, 2 times 3 is 6. And in the denominator, the square root of 3 times the square root of 3 is the square root of 9, which is simply 3. Now, I would not give this as my final answer because it simplifies. Remember, I can't simplify these numbers because that's inside and that's outside, but I can these because they're both outside. 3 divided by 3 is 1. So those cancel each other, leaving me with simply the square root of 6. So again, that's not the lesson today. That's all just review of Algebra 1 skills. So hopefully all of that looks familiar to you, and we can start our lesson now.